With me on Skype this morning from Rockfire Resources, I've got David Price. David, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew. How are you this morning?
Very good, thanks, David. Look, thanks for your time. You've had the new Leyshon exploration permit granted here today, David. Tell us a little bit more about this and the significance here.
Yes, Andrew, the granting of the Mount, the new Leyshon tenement is just part of our ongoing growth strategy for Rockfire. As I've made it clear before to investors, we've got a dual-pronged approach to growing the company. One is organic growth with our exploration programs, which are ongoing, and also inorganic growth, where we actually acquire new tenements. We are actively seeking other projects, and we assess projects all the time, but part of our strategy is to accumulate ground on a very low cost entry in and around our existing operations in North Queensland.
And why were you keen to accumulate this permit in particular? Why is this so exciting?
Well, New Leyshon sits just northwest of the Lighthouse tenement, which is our flagship tenement there in near Charters Towers. New Leyshon sits around maybe around 60 kilometres south of Charters Towers and immediately surrounds Newmont's mining lease on three sides. So it's strategically a very important portfolio acquisition for us, and it starts to zero in our ground holding on areas that have known mineral production. And in the case of Mt Leyshon, it's 2.5 million ounces of gold that has been mined there. So it's clearly a well-endowed area, and having a foothold in that area is a great place for us to be, and we're very excited about getting into some early stage exploration there.
And what would that early stage work involve? What are you looking at?
Originally, I'll be doing some ground magnetic surveys and some soil sampling on some of the structures that have been mapped there. There's a number of faults that run through the mining lease at Mt Leyshon itself, and they do pass through the tenement at New Leyshon that Rockfire has just been granted. So I'm keen to have a look at those structures in particular, and the first pass exploration will be ground magnetics and also the soil sampling, which will give us at least a good surface footprint on whether there's something there or not.
It's interesting. You talk about the ongoing growth strategy and this piece of land in particular, the opportunity it may present. Shares taking a slight dip this morning. What are you putting that down to?
Well, Andrew, I think the short-term share price for me is certainly not an issue. We have a deliberate strategy and a very determined growth strategy. The share price is always going to go up and down, and there's nothing I can do about that in the short term. But in the long term, I think investors want to make sure that they have a very focused management and that the strategy is correct. In my opinion, it's a great strategy for us to be accumulating ground in that area. And if there are investors that perhaps don't quite grasp what we're trying to achieve at Rockfire, then I really can't help them selling in the short term. So that's something that is completely out of my hands. All I have to do is do what I expect the investors want me to do, and that is to grow the company, get value for their shareholding, and to make sure that we test the ground as best we can and come up with, hopefully, we come up with a discovery. So that's the objective.
Well, look, just while I've got you, what else is happening within the portfolio? You've recently wrapped up drilling at Marengo. You must be expecting some results in the coming weeks here, are you?
Yes, we've got just over 550 samples in at the lab from the drilling we did at Marengo. And they've been in the lab about a week now, so I expect that we should be seeing some results coming through in the next few weeks. And that'll be interesting to see if we've actually hit something in that drilling at Marengo. Obviously, with the announcement that we put out that we have hit sulfides is encouraging for us. But I'm not really prepared to speculate on grade at this stage because it's the first drilling that we've done there. And I think it would be premature for me to comment on any potential grades there. So I am reluctant to do that. And I think we'll just have to wait. All of us have to wait, unfortunately, for those results to come through.
And what about Copperhead, David? What's the latest here?
Well, Andrew, I was up at Copperhead a couple of weeks ago doing some mapping up in there, and we were pushing through the bush to get up onto the top of the ridge, and it was quite an effort to get up there. So what we've got now is the landowner is fantastic for us. The landowners are doing such a great job for us. So he's got his bulldozer up there, and he's re-establishing the old tracks that were used in the 1972 drilling. So shortly we'll have really good access up onto the ridge there at Copperhead. And once we gain access, we'll be able to get a whole pile of work done, and you'll start to see some RNS coming through about the work that we're planning for Copperhead, which will include mapping. It'll include some additional conformation rock sampling, and also some geophysics to try and zero in on where that copper's coming from that they hid in the drilling then.
David, great to see you as always. Thanks for your time.
Okay, thanks again, Andrew.